So please note that the corporate bond or the treasury bonds, okay, these are your taxable bonds. So the bonds, you can see that, okay, we can break it into two type. One is a taxable bond or another is the tax free bond. Okay, your corporate bond, treasury bond comes under the taxable category. Tax free category, you get municipal bond. Okay, right. So or Tennessee Valley Association bonds are also tax free bond. Okay, so what happens is, how much tax you have to pay? It so happens the tax that you will have to pay, it depends on your marginal tax rate. Okay, so whatever is your marginal tax rate, you will have to pay tax according to it. Okay, please note that people may be in different tax brackets. So let's say if your investor one is in the 10% tax bracket, so he will pay the tax as per 10%. If investor two is at 20% tax bracket, he will pay tax as per 20%. Please note that these are tax-free securities, so you do not have to pay any tax. Okay. Now, what are the implications of this taxable thing? Okay. So the implication is, suppose this type of bond is giving you 10% per annum return. Okay. If the bond is giving you 10% per annum return and you are in 20% tax bracket, right? So do you realize this 10% per annum return, or do you realize a lower than this or higher than this? Okay. So since you are at a 20% tax bracket, you will have to pay tax on the money that you make from the bond, right? So if let's say the face value of the bond is $100, okay, and the bond has given you 10% coupon, let's say it's annual coupon, so you have received a $10 coupon, right? So you have to pay tax at the rate of 20% on this coupon that you have received. So you'll have to pay $2 as the coupon tax. So $2 as the tax. So your net money that you can bring at home is $8. So this is your money after tax, right? So this is your money which was coming before tax. So you should not be looking at this $10 that you are getting, but you should be looking at this $8 which you are getting after the tax that you have paid. Now, if you see, this $8 is nothing but, if you compare with the face value, it is 8%, right? So how this 8% has arrived? So this 8% has come. So you are saying that the after tax yield that you have got, which is 8%, is coming from the 10% only, but you have to subtract 0.2. So you have to multiply with, so here what you are doing is, okay, so you are subtracting 2. This 2 has come as 20% into 10. So 0.2 is 20%. So this is your tax rate. So this is your tax rate. So 1 minus tax rate into 10%. So your after tax yield is, this 10% is your before tax yield. So it is before tax yield into 1 minus your marginal tax rate. So until unless it is given, it is assumed that it is the marginal tax rate. So your after tax yield is this.